2 Corinthians 5, 17 and 21. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. 2 Timothy 3, 2-5. People will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy, without love, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not lovers of the good, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power, have nothing to do with them. Luke 12:2. For there is nothing covered that will not be revealed, nor hidden that will not be known. Did you hear that? Everything is gonna be revealed. We are gonna be judged. Hebrews 10:26 through 31. For if we go on deliberately and willingly sinning after once acquiring the knowledge of the truth, there is no longer any sacrifice left to atone for our sins, no further offering to which to look forward. There is nothing left for us then but a kind of awful and fearful prospect and expectation of divine judgment and the fury of burning wrath and indignation, which will consume those who put themselves in opposition to God. Any person who has violated and thus rejected and set at naught the law of Moses is put to death without pity or mercy on the evidence of two or three witnesses. How much worse, sterner, and heavier punishment do you suppose he will be judged to deserve who has spurned and thus trampled underfoot the Son of God, and who has considered the covenant blood by which he was consecrated common and unhallowed, thus profaning it and insulting and outraging the Holy Spirit who imparts grace, the unmerited favor and blessing of God? For we know him who said, "Vengeance is mine, retribution and the meting out of full justice rest with me. I will repay, I will exact the compensation, says the Lord." And again, the Lord will judge and determine and solve and settle the cause and the cases of his people. It is a fearful, formidable, and terrible thing to incur the divine penalties and be cast into the hands of the living God. 1 Corinthians 2:16. For who has known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ. Colossians 1:13. For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves.